हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। इन आवर टुडेज वीडियोस वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द कैपेसिटेंस ऑफ स्फेरिकल कंडक्टर। सी, एक्चुअली व्हाट वी हैव डन दैट इज द थियोरेटिकल कॉन्सेप्ट्स about the capacitance of isolated spherical conductor. Okay, so this article we have seen in our previous videos, that is capacitance of an isolated spherical conductor. Okay, but in today's videos there are applications on these whiteboards and we have to solve that applications. And for solving that applications we must know what about the capacitance of an isolated spherical conductor. So capacitance of an isolated spherical conductor, the concept is this one. So suppose this one is the spherical conductor, and if we want to capacitance of this spherical conductor having radius r, so we have a formula, that is capacitance of a spherical conductor is exactly equal to, that is 4 pi epsilon naught into r. So this one is the proper formula to calculate capacitance of spherical conductor. So C stands for here what? Capacitance. Capacitance, that is 4 pi epsilon naught into R. Now according to this concept, we already conclude that is capacitance is directly proportional to R. It means what? If the radius of a spherical conductor increases, then the capacitance also increases. So this concept we have seen already. Now we have to solve these applications. Okay, so let us solve first application. So in first application, which things are given to us? See, assuming earth to be an isolated conducting sphere. So what we have done here, just we are assuming earth is a isolated conducting sphere of radius, that is 6400 kilometer. So this one is the radius of the earth is given. Suppose we are considering this one is the earth and its radius is r. So the value of r is given, the value of r is 6400 kilometer. How we can write this kilo? Means what? 10 to the power 3, means 6400 into 10 to the power 3 meter. So this kilo stands for what? 10 to the power 3. But 1, 2, 3, so if we put here a decimal point, that is 4, 6.4 into, so the power becomes 6 meter. So the radius of earth is 6.4 into 10 to the power 6 meters. 10 to the power 6 meter, it means what? 6400 kilometers. So this is the conversion, kilometer into meter. Okay, so you should remember the value of radius of earth, that is 6.4 into 10 to the power 6. Now we are going to calculate here what? Capacitance. Okay, so capacitance means what? So capacitance can be calculated by using this formula, that is 4 pi epsilon naught into r. So we have the value of r. Now what about 4 pi epsilon naught? So there is a constant value which we have seen in our previous videos, that is 4 pi epsilon naught has a value, that is 1 upon 9 into 10 to the power 9. So you should keep in your mind, this one is the constant value of 4 pi epsilon naught is equal to 1 upon 9 into 10 to the power 9. If we can put the value of radius of earth and the value of 4 pi epsilon naught, then we can easily calculate value of capacitance. So therefore the value of capacitance will be So therefore we can write C is equal to, what is 4 pi epsilon naught? 4 pi epsilon naught has a value, that is 1 into 1 upon 9 into 10 to the power 9 multiplied by R, that is the radius of Earth. And what is radius of Earth? 6.4 into 10 to the power 6. Okay. So such applications are very simple, but you must know how we can calculate the capacitance. So this is most important. Capacitance, that is, capacitance is nothing but it is a 4 pi epsilon naught into R. Why? That is, capacitance is directly proportional to the radius. Now see, so the calculations of this capacitance, C is equal to 6.4 into 10 to the power 6 upon 9 into 10 to the power 9. Then the calculations of this, that is, it is approximately equal to 0.711. It is in millifarad. So its calculation is 0.711 into 10 to the power minus 3 farad. So this 10 to the power minus 3 indicates what? It is millifarad, okay? But if we want to write this millifarad into microfarad, then how we can write? We can write, that is, 1, 2, 3. So after putting decimal point after 3 digits, so it becomes minus 3, and already minus 3 is there. So 1711 into 10 to the power minus 6 farad, and this minus 6 stands for what? So this minus 6 represent, it is a microfarad. So we can write here the answer of this application, that is 1711 mu f means what? Microfarad. So this will be the capacitance of the Earth, because radius already given to us. Okay, so in this way we can calculate the capacitance of spherical conductor. Okay, so here conductor means what? You have to assume Earth as a isolated conducting sphere. Okay, now let us look at the second MCQs, that is, an isolated sphere has an capacitance of 50 picofarad. So here 50 picofarad, it is given capacitance, then calculate its radius. So we can write here given things. So in given, what is given? That is the capacitance, 50. Pico means what? 10 to the power minus 12 farad. Calculate radius R. So we have to find R, the value of R, and how much charge should be placed on it is raise its potential up to 10 to the power 4 volt. See here, 10 to the power 4 volt means what? Obviously it is potential difference. So we can put here potential difference, V is exactly equal to 10 to the power 4 volt. And what we have to find? How much charge means what? Q. So this is about the second applications. Okay, now how we can solve that second applications? How we can solve this second application? Now to solve the second application, we must know which things are given to us. Okay, so in an isolated sphere has a capacitance of 50 picofarad. 50 pico means what? 10 to the power 12 farad. Calculate its radius and how much charge should be placed on it is raise its potential to 10 to the power 4 volt. Now see, this is about the given. So this is about the given. Now how we can solve radius? So firstly, we want to calculate the value of radius, but we know how we can find out the radius of Earth, or we can say the radius of spherical conductor. So to find the radius of spherical conductor, you should place here the formula, particular formula. And what is the particular formula for capacitance? So we know for capacitance, C is equal to 4 pi epsilon naught into R, because capacitance and R, they are directly proportional. Okay, so therefore we have a formula for capacitance of an isolated spherical conductor. So MCQs which are depending on this article, that is capacitance of an isolated spherical conductor, it is so simple, because you must know the capacitance, that is capacitance is equal to 4 pi epsilon naught into R. Now see, a capacitance is given to you, and what you have to find, that is R. So here you have to find R. So to find R, how we can write, that is R is exactly equal to C multiplied by the reciprocal of 4 pi epsilon naught is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, and we know already the value of 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught because it is given in electrostat, and we have seen the constant value of that. But we can write the constant value for 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. This is called as K, electrostatic constant. And the value of that is 9 into 10 to the power 9. Okay, so you should keep in your mind the value of electronic constant. It is exactly equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, and it is 9 into 10 to the power 9. Okay, so we can put this given value. So we can put this given value here. So therefore R is exactly equal to, C capacitance. Capacitance is given. The capacitance is in picofarad, that is 50 into 10 to the power minus 12 farad, multiplied by the value of 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. And the value of 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught is 9 into 10 to the power 9, multiplied by 9 into 10 to the power 9. So the calculations of, or the multiplication of this, that is 5 9s are 45, 50 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 12 plus 9, it is minus 3. R radius is given, so it is in meter. Okay, so we can write, therefore R is equal to 45 into 10 to the power, instead of 10 to the power minus 3, we can put there minus 2. So R is exactly equal to 45 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 2 meter. And what is the value of 45 into 10 to the power minus 2 meter? So this is called as 45 centimeters. So this is equal to, 45 centimeter. So radius we calculate here, it is 45 centimeter, because in our second application, an isolated sphere has a capacitance of 50 picofarad. Calculate its radius. So if the capacitance of spherical sphere, it is given, that is 50 picofarad, then how we find here the radius of that sphere, isolated sphere? The radius of isolated sphere is 45 centimeter. Okay, so how much charge should be placed on it is raised to its potential. Now what we have to find, how much charge. So how much charge, which formula we can apply here? Because we know charge is directly proportional to the potential difference, therefore we can write Q is equal to C multiplied by V. So this is the proper formula to find out how much charge should be placed on it is raised its potential 10 to the power 4 volt. Okay, so using this formula we can put the values. which values are there? That is Q is exactly equal to C, where is C? C is capacitance. Put the value of capacitance 50 into 10 to the power minus 12 multiplied by voltage 10 to the power 4 volt. So 50 multiplied by minus 12 plus 4, it becomes minus 8. Okay. And we can write 5 into 10 to the power minus 7 coulomb. So this charge can be represented by Q, and Q it is measured in coulomb. Okay. So therefore, how much charge should be placed on it is raise its potential to 10 to the power 4 volt. So to calculate charge, we know the formula. Charge is equal to capacitance multiplied by what? Potential difference. So this C stands for capacitance, or we can say constant of proportionality. So it is given in 50 picofarad. So we write here 50 into 10 to the power minus 12 because of picofarad, and 10 to the power 4 volt, which is already given to us. So therefore, after substituting all the values in that particular formula, we get here Q is equal to 5 into 10 to the power minus 7 coulomb. So this one is the correct answer. Okay. I think you understand very well, because these concepts are very simple, and the MCQs which depending on the capacitance, it is also very simple. Okay. So we shall stop here. Till then, thank you.